the channel. If you're new here, welcome back. If you've been here before, and welcome to the Kia Picanto, an absolute marvel of motoring in the modern world. Well, some of them maybe. This one, however, is not. This is having a bit of an identity crisis at the minute because it's halfway between being a normal car, i.e. biscuit tin size car, and a camper. Although it looks like it's in the state of being a camper, it is quite deceiving. You see, it looks like it's all ready to go with a floor installed and everything in its place, but in actual fact, let me show you how it really looks. You see, reality can be a bit less impressive, if I'm honest. So in today's episode, I'm going to actually attach the floor into the car somehow. And more importantly, I'm going to be attaching and installing this bad boy. We're not going to be wiring it up, but it's going to go in the hole down here. It just fits snug as a rug. So I think first, we'll deal with the battery. And because I haven't got the tools, even though I went out a few weeks ago and bought an absolute mass of them, yeah, I don't have the tool I need for the battery, so I'm gonna go and have to see a man that has got the tools. Boom. Well, gotta say, not just good news, great news. My mate has saved the day yet again, not just with one thing, but two things. We've got the strap that I need to do the job. I'll tell you about that in a minute. And the about the only tool that I haven't got, and also the tool I need to do the job. My logic's this, and it's simple. My mate does banger racing, or used to do banger racing, and they move their batteries out the front of the car and put them into the back or middle, and then have to strap it down. And this is what they use to strap them down. If it's good enough for banger racing, then it should be good enough for me. And hopefully all I've got to do to install it is mark a slit here, a slit here, cut it, and then insert the strap. How difficult can it be? I'm gonna have to give this car a clean at some point. I can barely even see me mark. But not today. For today, it's all about new tools and installing, because we've got new tools. All right, it's not exactly a tool, but it's going on a tool and it'll protect its eyes. Good news. Okay, we might have a slight problem here. You see, I can see daylight on that one, but I couldn't see daylight on this one. Let me show you why. Oh, this is going to be difficult to show you, but look, there's the one where we can see the daylight. And, genius, here's the one that we can't, because, well, whatever this is, the old tow bar thing, it's in the bloody way. Damn it! Oh, I don't know how I can do this, and it's actually sealed there as well, so I don't know. Oh, bear with. Simple job, never easy, but I've surmised a cunning plan. Simple as this. Well, literally Ashley's told me what to do. Drill a big hole in there, feed it through, and then just drill all the way through so it comes through and we can feed the strap through. Or rather, I can feed the strap through. Good news as well, means I get to use my power tools for the first time ever. Legend. Only problem is, which drill do we use? I think this one. Well, I don't know if it's the drill bit or the drill, but that's not going through. Nightmare.
3 days later.
Well, back at the homestead, and said battery is finally installed with the strap. I've got to be honest, I'm really chuffed with this. It wasn't the easiest drilling through here to make the hole so I could actually feed the strap through, but once I realized the electric drill actually drills two ways and I was drilling anti-clockwise and needed to go clockwise, the job became a little bit more easy. No, I'm joking, but yeah, it was a bit of a pain trying to get it through there. But let me tell you about this battery, because I know some of you that are regular to the series are going to be scratching your head wondering why I'm not using one of my portable power units. And yeah, that would have been the easiest way to get power in here, admittedly. But here's the thing, I want to do a proper van build on this car. I want to make it quirky and I want to make it cool. And at the heart of most van builds, let's be honest, is a leisure battery, which is exactly what that is. I need to get DC to DC converter cables. I've got an inverter already, and I may at some point be getting MPPT solar panel gubbins to go with it as well.
Yeah, I want to do a proper van build.
And in all honesty, if you're going to install a leisure battery into a vehicle and you want to make sure it's a good one, and that is an amazing battery. Let me tell you a little bit about it in a minute. This has been sent over by a company called Lifetime, who specialise in making leisure batteries. They distribute them worldwide to a number of countries, including France, Germany, America, and have just started distributing them also in the UK. On their website, there's two batteries, a 100 amp hour one and this one, which is 12.8 volt, 200 amp hour, rocking out at over 2.5 kilowatts of power for you to use. It discharges at 100 amp hours, which means you can plug in up to 1200 watts of power at any one time. And what makes this battery so cool is it's built for the future. Forget your old school lead acid batteries that only recharge 200 to 500 times and you're gonna be replacing them every 2 to 4 years. No, this is lithium, but not any lithium, no. It's LiFePO4, so it's gonna be rechargeable for 10 to 15 years. You're never re-swapping this one out. In terms of quality, it's considered to be a budget end battery, but after hours of research on YouTube, watching tons of rip down videos, the general consensus on this battery is that it's been put together very, very well, with straps around the batteries and laser soldering points all over. It's been really well put together and it's definitely at the top end of a budget battery. I'll leave a link in the description where you can go and check it out, the 200 amp hour Lifetime battery. I can't wait to finally use it in the biscuit tin. As for now, let's get the flooring. So here's the thing, I want to keep this really simple today. I'm just going to keep all that in and I'm going to screw the boards into that, and then I'm essentially going to screw the boards into here and possibly here. I was thinking of maybe building another box sort of thing to sit in there to give more support, but this really isn't going to last very long in here. So I think for today, we'll just keep it really simple. I'm going to have to pack this out with some material and some sort of gluey stuff over there, so I'm not trapping this cable, because let's be honest, that's to the petrol tank and that's pretty important that it doesn't get destroyed. So I need to pack that up a little bit and then we screw in there, and we're job done.
I should say at this point, if you haven't worked it out already, we have a saying that goes that you can't polish a turd and make it shine. And in terms of my DIY skills, yep, I'm that turd. Don't matter how many times I try, I'm never gonna get good at it. I'm not sure if that analogy works, but it definitely is apt. But life's about having a go, so I'm gonna have a go.
Well, if you look from a distance and you squint your eyes, it looks fantastic. In reality, if you get close up, it doesn't. But you know what? I don't care. I'm absolutely psyched. I've finally got a floor in, and to top it off, check this out. Boom time, blue skies. I kid you not, it's been persisting it down with rain for about 8-9 days. Even when I was putting this floor in the other day, I got drenched, not once but twice, just trying to get it in. So because it's blue skies and we got a new floor in, I think we should go and test it out. I've got a wicked little spot, familiar area, but a place we've never stayed before, and something quite funky to go and check out. So I think I can finally remove the mucky coffee cup and we can load it up for a few bits. Oh, let's do this.
Legend.
I actually had a little spot lined up near the homestead in Leicester.
live with tonight, but I've got to be honest, I'm well glad I've come up here. He's teeming though, so busy. Look at this, this is mad. I hope I can find a spot where I want to be. Damn. Oh, check it out, the old Stannage Edge in all its glory with the sun beaming over top of it, mate. This is a beautiful summer's evening. Right, we're in scoping mode, believe it or not. Got a few new spots I want to check out down here. Right, I'm going to hazard a guess that this is our first option, which probably ain't going to be an option because of what it is. Yeah, check it out. But yeah, the sat-nav's abandoned me. I don't know what's going on. It's a paying display, and if there ain't a no overnight parking sign here, then I'll eat my hat, and I don't normally wear one, but I'll find one. And there's the sign. Yeah, bollocks. Seriously, I'm following part for night. I don't even know why they bother anymore, man. Just delete them. I'm sick of seeing them. Sick of seeing them signs as well, but there we go. Right, next spot. I think we can do better than this anyway. There is two spots that, well, you just ain't gonna stop me stopping there because, yeah, I'll show you. And, to be honest, I think they'll have better views than this anyway. That's nothing special or anything to write them about, you know, so keep moving. Look at the scratches on my window. Gutted. I don't know if you can see it. I'm going to end up getting a new windscreen at some point. I've got to be honest. For now, it don't matter because I think this is us. Wait up. Oh, that just does not look flat at all. And one thing I didn't bring with me is my chocks. Oh, man. It's doable. Oh, my days. I think this might be the spot, you know. Look at that for a view out the back. Wow. Yeah, I could cope with that for the night, I think. Or maybe that over that side. Oh, wow. You know what? I was going to go for an early evening bumble. There's another spot up the way. I don't know, 2 minute drive, probably about 10 minute walk. I don't think I'm going to. I think I'm just going to chill here, set the crib up, cook up some food and enjoy this spot. This is going to be a nice evening, this. Probably got about hour and a half's worth of light. Yeah. Let's do some chill wrestling. I've got a good one to cook tonight. I've not. Oh, but it'll feed me. Oh, my days. It's absolute chaos in there. Give me a minute. Game on. Ah, oh, it's looking a bit more doable. I've got my airbed, but I haven't pumped it up as yet. But yeah, rocking it with a Superman bedspread. Cooker, new one. Oh mate, check this out. It's a double hobber, I'll show you in a little bit. All the gubbins, and yeah, that's about as good as it gets, to be honest. In all honesty, there's stuff everywhere. There's no storage space, let me show you the reality of it. One bag outside that obviously I'll drag in, and that'll have to sit somewhere over there. And then, yeah, at the front, looks good. Got things stuffed in here. This is like my only storage space in the whole car. Look at it. I could just about get my hand in there. And possibly might be able to get a couple of pieces of paper in there somewhere. I'm just going to get my hand in there. Apart from that, that's it. Like, pretty much, yeah, maybe. But you're not getting much of any size in there, are you? And then under here, well, yeah, that's pretty limited as well. I mean, yeah, I can get my hand in. But then, what can you get in there? Not a lot. I mean, no. Maybe some clothes stuffed in there, that's about your lot. So yeah, iteration one on the biscuit tin. It's all right, but it needs work. I think when I do it again, I'm going to raise the floor a lot more just to give myself like some options of having that storage space, because this car's never going to have much space for storage. I've just got to face that. And I don't really want a roof box because I've always had roof boxes on it. I want to go something a little bit different on this one if it's possible. I'd like to get a roof rack and then maybe a box on that roof rack and enough space for me to chill in the morning having a coffee on the roof. Not in the winter though. But yeah. Right. I think I'm going to have a brew and I'm going to enjoy this area. Look at this spot. This is wicked. Beautiful views all around. Sun setting in the backdrop. I've never been, well, I have. I've drove this road 1,000 times, but I've never stopped along it. I've even got a stream at the back here and potential right there for a wild camp. You could definitely pitch your tent there. And you'd have that view for the evening. And you, like, your car can be there. How legendary would that be for a little sneaky wild camp just for an evening? Like, 100 metres, not even, 20 metres from your car and
Beautiful spot. It's almost like Devon, like Dartmoor or something at this spot. Yeah, well tempted. Now I showed you. I won't be able to use it. More importantly, I'm going to chill for a bit and then look at getting this food on. I'm absolutely starving, to be honest. Just had a few little nibbly bits all day, so yeah. Wicked, mate. Out in nature. Beautiful. She looks like she's in her element as well, don't she? She needs to get to Europe. The Alps. And will it fit? Oh my days, it does. Oh, that's legendary. I honestly didn't think I'd be able to get 2 pans on there of that size. That's wicked. One of you guys sent me this. Really appreciate it. Little Van Gogh cooker. How cool is that? We can now cook a proper meal with 2 hobs. Moving up in the world, don't you know? Oh, all the mod cons. Happy days. Wicked. Right. Even though we've got a nice fancy cooker, what? I'm going to cook something a bit not so fancy. Let's say that. What's in the box tonight, Dr. Cotton? Not a lot, actually, because we've got a carrier bag instead of a box. Yeah, I haven't got the fridge with me, have we? Got a cooler box with me. I don't know why I even bothered bringing that with me. I brought it with me, and then I remembered to plug it in when I pulled up. So it's now not a cooler box, it's just a box. More importantly, tonight's meal. And I don't know why I bought this, but I just had a bit of a craving flavouring for it. I don't know. Eggs. Beans. Good brand, don't you know? Yeah, stole them from the cupboard at home. No one's noticed yet. And the piece de resistance. Da-da-da-da. Spam. Oh, hello, it's not spam. I couldn't get spam. Oh, can you believe it? In all the world of food, and I couldn't get spam. So I went for the next best thing, a bacon grill. They did have porky stuff that was kind of more like spam, but it was circular. It wasn't the shape of spam. I mean, that's really spam, because spam's pork, isn't it, I think. And I'm assuming that's pork, because it says bacon. But yeah, and I may or may not throw a couple of rashers of bacon in. Mate, just a fry up, just a feed and a chill with a view in the evening. What a spot and what a night. It's legendary, just getting out in the Kia. I'm genuinely psyched, I really am. It's been a blooming long time getting to this point, and it really does feel now I've got to this point, even though I'm going to rip it out again, that it's going to get done and it's going to happen. I'm going to be able to get a decent flooring, get all the gubbins with the electric sorted, and then maybe after that start thinking about some sort of proper cooking units and such. Yeah, I'm really chuffed. Currently don't know how long this stuff's going to take to cook, so I don't know. I guess I'll cook this one first. Ow. I mean, I'm only putting heat through it, really, but, you know. Oh, mate. Oh. Yeah, that's not spam. Look at the state of the colour of that. That looks... Oh, that smells weird, dude. That looks like chicken. Like some random, weird chicken spam thing. Baking my arse. Oh, that smells funky, dude. Got it. I knew I should have like held out and gone in and got the proper stuff. I bought this from bloody Pollock. Pollock don't sell spam. They're too good for spam. Oh, yeah. Damn it. Oh, no. Oh, I don't know what this is. Smells like something my grandma used to cook on a Sunday morning. That's minging. Ugh. And honestly, not the best bloody start to tonight's proceedings, really, is it? I mean, that's the main shitting. Got it. Oh, bloody hell, here we go. Oh, come on. Oh, bear with. Maybe I can do it with this. Maybe not. Maybe I can prise it with the knife and work my way around. And that'll loosen it off. No, that didn't work. Dude, this is the lamest thing ever, man. Oh, it's nearly coming. Oh, come on, dude. Yes, sir. Oh, he's not out yet. He's not out of the woods yet. Oh, my days. Come on. You can do it. Oh, bloody Nora.
You think of making a mountain out of a molehill, don't you, really? But you got to think, the true spam can. Oh, well, it comes with one of them things, you know, them twisty things that if you turn it the wrong way, you're in a world of pain. But if you turn it the right way, it opens a can, but it opens a can like a third or a quarter of the way down. So you're already halfway enterprising the meat out. Part, mate, taking the piddle. Anyway, let's slice her up and chuck her in. All right, and you're getting 6 out of that. It's way too much. I'm thinking about saving a little bit for breakfast, you know. It's true, I took the beans out the cupboard at home and it may cause a little bit of dismay. Oh, I reckon the last bit of cooking oil might cause even more gutted. Anyway, not to worry about it, I'm not there. There is one thing this cooker doesn't have, or at least I don't think it has. It hasn't got an auto lighter. Oh, so you got to do that. But you can regulate. Look at that bad boy. And look, it's not going off. Have a little bit of a piddly frame or a bad boy. Might move it away from that seatbelt just for a second. Anyway, we're on. Let's go. For God's sake. Bloody hell, where's it gone? Bloody corners just fell off on the plastic. I don't know why they bother, man. It's ridiculous. Anyway. Oh, mate, regulate. Bloody Nora, we're going mental here. I can see it burning. I ain't even got the bacon out yet. Oh my bloody hell. I'm going rogue. There's no plan for this one. In with the bacon as well at the same time. Fingers crossed. And raw. Check it out. God darn it. Bacon jizz. Blech. I ain't got no bloody cloths either. Got it. Wipe it on me sock, mate. That's minging. Ta-da. Oh, mate. Now that's a cooking session. Beans on. Bacon and the old spammy wannabe thing. In all seriousness, I mean, wow, put in context, sat in the back of a Kia Picanto cooking a meal up on a double hob. I mean, this could be the future in here. You get a decent little cooker area thing going on. Yeah, man, wicked. It's going somewhere, this crib, on site. There is one thing though, now I'm cooking the gas. Man, I'm really paranoid that I screwed a screw into the petrol tank. I'm pretty sure I haven't, and I'm pretty sure if I had, I'd smell it by now, but yeah, the one right underneath me, yeah, that was difficult to get in. I'm not sure where it went. It didn't go in the petrol tank, though. We'd have blown up by now, and I'd have smelled it. Food's nearly burnt. Bear with. Damn it, the oat broke. Man. All right, food time. Proper little fry up, don't you know? Wicked. Oh, we got a problem from the start. Hang on a minute. Oh, don't do that. Ow! Why would you do that? Bloody hell! Oh, bloody hell! He's turning into chaos. The beans are not liquefying. They're just. Yeah, they're burning. Christ, if you can burn beans. I'm sure I can. Nah. Oh, bugger. Damn it. Just get on my plate. Come on already. Sliming out the side. Come on, dude. Be good. Oh, yeah. Damn it. I've got schmuck on the floor. Oh, that's a lot of juice. It's a lot of juice. Wow, that was close. Yeah. Oh, now my cooker's got it. Oh my God. Slipping off. Hey, bear with. Oh, that looks a pretty good feed. I was so glad those beans didn't drip off the side. It is, however, missing one thing. Sneaky bit of ketchup, you know. I know. Goes with everything. Definitely going to need a bit more to mop up that spam thing. Blech. Right. Should be right. I don't know. Let's try it. I mean, let's be honest. It weren't cheap, was it? It's from bloody Pawok, so could have bought bloody steak anywhere else for the price of it. Let's just disguise the flavour a little bit. Damn. I hope it tastes better than it smells. Not really. No. Borderline doable. Shan't be buying it again. Real spam would have been better. Right, I'm going to chill for a bit, eat this, and... Yeah, just enjoy this spot. Check out the sunset over this side. Look at the colours. I don't know if you're getting through the window properly, but this is a real nice evening.
Hello, my hands up. A proper lastminute.com. Just chucked on Google last night in the wee hours. Looked for a little spot not too far to come out, test out the floor, and yeah, I think it's worked out well. A little bit of passing traffic, but that was expected. But yeah, I'll catch you in a bit. Morning. Oh, wow. Good night's sleep. In the end, last night. Oh, you see, my body clock's out a little bit at the minute. I've been sleeping really late. Last night alone, I didn't get sleep till 2:30 in the morning, but it's probably a bit of a godsend, to be fair. Because at 3:00 in the morning, the only car to pass me in the whole night went past me. And he didn't go past me, did he? He drove up the way, and then 30 seconds later, he spun round, sped back down the road and came to a screech right next to my car. 3:00 in the morning and a bloody car screeching to a stop next to me. As it did, I started coughing to let them know that there was somebody in the car. I don't think I heard it though, because I could hear one of them going, "Oh, easy," and sounded like they were starting to get out of the car. So I grabbed the keys and unlocked the car with a central locking, which then sets all the lights off around the car, indicators. They saw that, shit themselves, jumped back in the car and sped off as fast as he could. Which just made me think, like, if I hadn't have been in the car, what was going through their stupid little heads to do to the car? Were they going to smash it? Were they going to break into it? Or what? No knowledge or knowing what they would have done. But I guarantee that they would have done something. Kids just driving around wanting to cause problems and damage and vandalism. And I say this as well, because I've had it in comments on previous videos. This would not be happening in America, because in America, guns are legal. Can you imagine speeding to a screeching halt next to somebody's car in the middle of the night in America? The geezer in the car could have a gun. The first thing he'd do is jump out and start shooting you. It's not happening, is it? But this is blighter. We're a law unto ourselves. Unfortunately, it'll happen again at some point, but not this morning. Because this morning, it's all about coffee, oh, and I need a lot of it. Good news, I've had coffee. I could probably do with one more, but yeah, I've had a little bit. Bad news, it's persisting it down with rain. It's drizzle, it's not heavy, but yeah, for those of you that are not from the UK, well, this is the heart of summer. It's freaking middle of July, dude. Man, I waited all year for this time of year and now it's here. Christ, I think I want winter back, you know. But hey, at least we got the views. Not a bad spot for the night, gotta say. And more importantly for now, it's only a 2-minute park up from the start of the head of the trail. You know what I mean? Nothing too strenuous today, hopefully. About a 45-minute hike. I'm just hunting something funky out in the moorlands, and to make it a bit interesting, well, I haven't got trail app, trail, or much knowledge of how to get there. I have got a Google satellite image. Let's hope the signal holds out. Ah, here we go. This was my other option for a park up last night, the one that I didn't check out. Looks like we've got a lay-by thing going on down here with a view of the old Stanage. Not as impressive as the view I had last night, to be honest, but there's a reason I didn't stay here or really bother checking it out. I think you've got to pay. And now I'm here. No, you haven't got to pay. That's a bit random. There's a thing on Park for Night. I'll throw it up on the screen now. And it says you've got to pay to park here in the day. And, well, it didn't say anything about overnight, but that's why I've not drove up here this morning. Oh, this is absurd. Weird. Maybe I got the spot wrong, but yeah, I don't know. Not a bad little spot. I think we got the better choice down the way. There might have been a couple of campers up here last night. I might have had a bit of company, eh? But yeah, we didn't. Oh, no way. This doesn't look like I'm going to be able to get to what I want to go to. I'm pretty sure I need to go that way. I can't go through this fence, can I? This is random. Bear with. Well, here's a good one. I can't find a way over this fence yet, but I have found something pretty funky. And I saw this on a video the other day.
wait for it, a couple of people foraging for bilberries.
Did you say bilberries?
I'm gonna get it wrong again. She told me about 30 times. Bilberries, yes, look, they're like a wild berry. And to be honest, they're pretty good. They don't have any hallucinogenic properties though, do they?
No, I'm afraid not.
Okay.
You have to lock on that one.
Probably should have asked you that earlier, but yeah.
They're a superfood.
They're a superfood. In 20 minutes, I'm gonna feel absolutely super. Wonderful. Right, we move on. Good news. I've found a way through the fence, or over the fence, or there was a gap in the fence. Bad news. I think that's what I'm heading to, but there's no trail. I'm just pure bushwhacking. It's a bit hard work as well. It's a bit moist and a bit spongy, but yeah, not too far to go. I honestly don't get why there's not a trail up to this thing. It's a bit weird. It's like, I mean, it's not a massive thing or anything, but it's on the map and it's prominent, you know. So anyway, hopefully there won't be any bogs, streams or walls to climb over from here on in. Mate, sheep are looking well up here. This one here just been wagging his tail looking over. Looks well chuffed. Anyway, let's keep moving. Oh man, this area's a killer. I've nearly snapped an ankle about 8 times. It's like that terrain where you sort of, you're walking along and all of a sudden, it's really nasty. I don't think it's helping. I've got like these, I don't know what they are. They're like these really little dainty ankle socks on. I don't know where they came from. They just appeared in my drawer. So I put them on because they were clean and didn't have holes in like most of my other ones. They were great when I was wearing my trainers last night, but blimey, they feel really odd wearing them with these hiking boots. Anyway, oh crap. I was going to say we're getting closer, but now I don't see it on the horizon. It's that way. Okay, I've been walking around almost in circles, going the wrong way, for about 15 minutes. I've got to be honest, I think I'm pretty close to the spot. I'm not seeing much. Bear with. Ah, fucking hell, nearly went then. Oh, I told you, ankle breaker, bloody hell. Oh, hang on a minute. I might have found it. I really hope I didn't build this one up too much because it ain't much to look at. Hang on. I'm surprised I couldn't bloody see it. I mean, oh jeez, bloody Nora. Yeah, I thought the floor was higher than it was. One of them. Yes, the Bamford Moor stone circle. Look at this bad boy. What do you reckon? Some old school pagan ritual site. That's wicked, man. Ah, it's a bit of a, I don't know, I kind of like, I was wondering whether like just people have messed about and put stones here, but no, I think this is a legit stone circle. And I can most definitely feel the power. In all seriousness, pretty cool little spot. Middle of the moors, up in the Peak District. None too shabby for, I think, a Tuesday morning-ish. Smells fresh as well. Good times again, eh? Only an hour up the road from where I live. Pretty sweet, man. Right, I think for now, I can't find the bloody car again. I think it's somewhere over there. I should have walked a straight line from here, but I went up there and then, yeah, not a straight line. Let's put it that way. Right. I think I'll catch you back at the crib, eh? Wicked. What a day, man. Nice. What a little trip. What a great little trip. Oh, mate. She's in her element. Look at her. Wicked. Oh, mate. Oh, the weather's as grim as your grandma's mole. I didn't think I'd be saying that in the middle of summer, but oh, well, it is what it is. I think this is going to be a good time to do my home run and a good point to end this episode. It's been good getting out in the Kia, but I've got to be honest, it's just made me think a lot more about redesigning it, how I'm going to get my stuff in here for storage, and then even more design for how I'm going to make it practical for me as a YouTuber to be traveling around cooking and possibly editing in the back of it. It's a lot of work to go, but it's going to be fun. As for now, think this will be the best point to end this episode. I really hope you enjoyed it. It's a bit skitty here and there. We've done a bit on the car and we've been out for a bumble. It's been a good one. If you enjoyed it, all the good stuff, hit the like button, subscribe to keep up with the series, and definitely hit me in the comments. And as always, big love to everybody who watches the channel and subscribes, donates on PayPal, buy me a coffee, and channel members alike. As always, you do, from a bit of a foggy, rainy Peak District area, take it easy, enjoy the camp, and stay stealthy. All right.